Now let us look at other kinds of examples. So affirmative to negative. Every mother loves her child. There is no mother but loves her child. This seems a little unconventional, this kind of statement, which we generally don't see, but this is the right one, which actually means there is no mother who does not love her child. So we can write it in both the ways, but this is the most, technically the most correct one. Therefore, any time when we are using everyone or everybody or every person, that means every plus the common noun, this all will be replaced by there is no plus the attached word or that common noun and but. Next, as soon as the thief saw the police, he ran away. No sooner had the thief seen the police than he ran away. So as soon as is replaced by what? No sooner had. And then in between will be the statement and then and again the rest part of the statement. Again, affirmative to negative. Dhaka is the biggest city in Bangladesh. No other city is as big as Dhaka in Bangladesh. Again, another type of rule that we look over here, when there is a superlative degree used. For example, the biggest over here, it's a superlative degree. So when there is a superlative degree, that means there is no comparison over here with any one particular person, and therefore we say no other plus the attached word, that is the common noun, plus as or so. So it could be either as or so, positive form of the word. So we are using in the earlier one the superlative degree, now it would be the positive degree. Again, as and the subject. So it's a rule is bigger, but if you look at it, it's a very simple thing. When you are using superlative degree, then when replacing it with or transforming it to the negative form of the sentence, then superlative word will change into the positive form. And when we are changing it into positive form, automatically these words will fall into places. I shall remember you. Very simple. I shall not forget you. So remember is a positive and forget is not forget is the negative part of it. So sometimes affirmative sentences are changed into negative by using the opposite words also. Then, Raven always attends the class. Raven never misses the class. Again, we see the opposite word, always and never. We had seen it earlier also. He is too weak to walk. He is so weak that he cannot walk. So we are seeing that too, adjective and too. This is the word in positive or affirmative form of the statement. And when we change into negative, then it is replaced by so, adjective and that. So can or could not, whichever in the past tense. Simi was as wise as Rimi. Now here there are two people who are compared, the adjective, degree of comparison that we use. So Simi was not less wise than Rimi. Therefore we have to compare it between those two people only. We cannot bring any other component there. And so the rule as and as, in between there is the word, the adjective over here. In negative will be replaced by not less, adjective than. Again, the next rule, the sun sets in the west. It's a fact. Does not the sun set in the west? So universal truth are changed by making them negative interrogative. This is 12th rule in affirmative to negative, which very few people generally use. So the universal truth is always put into negative interrogative because there cannot be any replacement to it. Ragini sometimes visits me. Ragini does not always visit me. So opposite again, sometimes, not always. Then I have many friends. I do not have a few friends. Again, we look at it many, few, opposites. So I have many friends. I do not have a few friends. So many and not a few. Delhi has a few scholars. Delhi does not have many scholars. This is rule 15. So a few will be replaced by not many. Simple. This is all opposite that we are talking of, opposite adjectives. Okay. They have much wealth. They do not have a little wealth. So opposite. If they do not have a little wealth, they have much wealth. Or they have a little wealth, they do not have much wealth. Either way, it would be the transformation. Then Daisy has a little riches. Daisy does not have much riches. So this is the negative, affirmative. Now we come to assertive to interrogative. So he was very gentle, assertive. Wasn't he very gentle? Interrogative. Does the meaning change? If you look at it, no. But the form has totally changed. Earlier one was a statement and now we have a question. Okay, he is not a good person. Is he a good person? See the change of auxiliary also. Then, if a sentence is in affirmative, then change it into negative interrogative. And if it is in negative, then change it into bare interrogative or only interrogative. So affirmative is changed into negative interrogative. And if a negative interrogative is there, then you have to just put it the opposite way. He plays football. Does he play football? So over here, again, does is the understood auxiliary. They did not play football yesterday. Now where did has come, it is written, because when there is negative, then we have to use the auxiliary. Did they play football yesterday? So no auxiliary verb, change it by using do, does, did, or don't, doesn't, didn't. This we have seen earlier also, that when there is no auxiliary, then generally did. The form of did or do is what we have to consider, depending on the tense of the sentence, depending on how the sentence is written. I never drink tea. Do I ever drink tea? So never, ever. And again, do is the form of auxiliary. So never is replaced by ever. And the earlier one that we saw, if no auxiliary, then did, do, or does. Assertive to interrogative again, everybody wishes to be happy. Who doesn't wish to be happy? If we would have transformed into negative, then it would be nobody wishes to be unhappy. But now it is interrogative. So who doesn't wish to be happy? Because we have to form a question. Everybody, everyone and all is replaced by who, is there any, and again the form of do. Every man wishes to be happy. Now, is there any man who does not or who doesn't wish to be happy? Again, now every is used, so is there any? Then nobody could count my love for you. So over here the word is used, nobody could count my love for you. Who could ever count my love for you? So it has changed to interrogative. Nobody, one person, and therefore who. Nobody, no one, or none will be replaced by who. Then, there is no use of this law. This is an assertive statement in a negative form. So, what is the use of this law? Answer, there is no use of this law. There is no man happier than Jameel. Who is happier than Jameel? There is no is replaced by is there any or who or what. Any of these things could be used. So is there any man happier than Jameel? Who is happier than Jameel? These are two in terms of people. And what would be coming in terms of thing, like the earlier one, what is the use of this law? It is no use of taking unfair means in the exam. Why take unfair means in the exam? Or is there any use of this law? Or is there any use of taking unfair means in the exam? So it is no is replaced by is there any or why. It does not matter if you fail in the exam. What though if you fail in the exam? Again, a little unconventional, but what does it matter if you fail in the exam would also be a form of interrogative. So it doesn't matter can be replaced by what though, does it matter if you fail in the exam, all such things where you can ask a question. So interrogative to assertive is using the rule vice versa. That means you get an answer to the question, an immediate answer to the question, because it is assertive and interrogative. So interrogative is question and assertive is the answer. Exclamatory to assertive. So subject and verb of exclamatory sentence are to be used as subject and verb of assertive sentence at the outset of the sentence. That means at the right at the start of the sentence. So how fortunate you are. Now over here, if you look at the mark, exclamation mark, you see that the mark has changed to a full stop. And when we change this mark, we cannot write how fortunate you are. We just write the sentence in the opposite way. You are very fortunate. Second rule, sometimes the subject and verb may be eclipsed. What do you mean by eclipsed? Revolving around. So what a beautiful scenery. It is a very beautiful scenery. Same type, but there is an addition of very. Then, rule 3, when we are using hurrah or bravo, such kind of words in exclamatory sentence, then it has to be replaced by I rejoice or we rejoice that, or it is a matter of joy. So, hurrah, we have won the game. It is a matter of joy that we have won the game. It becomes a plain statement. Then alas can be replaced by I mourn or we mourn that, or it is a matter of sorrow or grief. So alas, he has failed. We mourn that he has failed. Rule 5, had, were, if, would that at the outset. When a statement starts with such kind of words, then it will replace that I wish. Then the subject again plus were or had or, and the rest of the statement. So, had I the wings of a bird. This is a hope. This statement is a hope, and therefore we will see such kind of statement are hopes and wishes, and therefore we start with I wish. I had the wings of a bird. So, it is repetition only. The statement over here, the word had converts into wish, and no exclamation in the assertive, it is the full stop. So assertive to exclamatory, again use the rule vice versa, it becomes just the opposite. Imperative to assertive, do the work, it's an imperative statement. You should do the work is an assertive statement, very simple. So add the subject plus should, because should shows the command when we are looking at it as a form of command. Let us look at the request. Please help me. You are requested to help me. So the word changes over here and we have to say what is the emotion that we are speaking of. So please or kindly can be replaced by the subject plus auxiliary you are and requested to. Do not run in the sun. You should not run in the sun. Again, it is not purely command but an advice. So, should is a more proper auxiliary or an auxiliary which is showing that there is some advice given. So, do not is replaced by the subject plus should not. Never tell a lie. You should never tell a lie. Again, a kind of a command or request. Never is replaced by subject and should never. Let us go out for a walk. We should go out for a walk. This is not a command but just a kind of entreaty, trying to tell somebody to agree with you. So let us is replaced by we should. Should has a very important role to play in imperative to assertive. Let him play football. He might play football. So might also comes in here. and shows that there is some kind of entity that is put in. So let plus noun or pronoun can be replaced by subject plus might. Now this is for today, the transformation of sentences, and we saw the different kinds of sentences that we have, and we do not change the meaning of the sentence, but the sentence could be written in many forms to convey what we feel about it. So thank you, friends. Hope you have a nice day.